Hello everyone, I am Chayan Vinayak Goswami, and this is where our journey of learning about shader development begins. In this chapter, we will understand what is a shader, and to define shader, I will use simple terminology. So first, we will understand what is a shader. When we ask computer to perform any operation, we give an instruction to it. And a set of instructions is called as program. And a program that is used or contribute to shade or draw something on the screen is called as shader. Shader is a set of instruction that is run on GPU, which is a graphics processing unit. GPU is a processing unit or a circuit specially designed for faster and efficient computer graphics operation or image manipulation. If we briefly take a look at the comparison of GPU and CPU, so this is a CPU with 4 cores in it, and this is a GPU with thousands of cores in it. These 4 cores of CPU are designed for serial operations, whereas in GPU, the cores are designed for parallel operations or simultaneous operations. So that's how fast GPU is in comparison to CPU. Now, let's understand the types of shaders based on their functionality. So first type of shader is vertex shader. Then there is pixel shader. Then there is geometry shader and compute shader and tessellation or hull shader. So these are the basic type of shaders divided based on their functionality. In this series, we will emphasize on vertex and the pixel shaders. And before we start understanding vertex and pixel shaders, let's understand why there is even a need of shader. Why do we need shaders? When we have to show or draw any object on the screen, it will be in the form of primitives or a mesh. If it is a geometry of a specialized character in the game, or even if it is a texture. Even if we have to draw a texture, we will have to draw a card of the mesh and then we will draw a texture on top of it. And even if we shade something, we will draw a mesh first and then shade it. Or if it is an emitting object, if we want to show any emitting object, we will have to draw the shape of that object first. So it comes down to drawing a mesh, which is then divided into primitives. And what is primitives? These are the basic units of a mesh, which is a triangle, a line, or a point. So if we have to draw a triangle on the screen, our first task is to draw the vertices. Because what mesh is made up of, it's made up of vertices. And in order to draw these vertices, we will use our first type of shader, which is called as vertex shader. So we will collect the information of vertices and give it to our vertex shader to draw them on the screen. Our next problem is how we will fill the area in between these vertices. In other words, how we will shade the pixels of the screen in the region of this geometry. And we will use pixel shader to perform that operation. Pixel shader is also known as fragment shader, and it's a type of shader that works on a pixel or a fragment. A term fragment is used to define an element that is eventually contribute to the final color of the pixel. So fragment is like a presidential candidate. A candidate can be a president, it cannot be a president, or it can contribute to a president. In the later chapters, we will see how fragment contributes to the final color of the pixel. So now we will get an overview of tessellation shader. Tessellation shader is also known as hull shader, and they are relatively new shaders. They are added in OpenGL 4 and DirectX 3D 11. In a nutshell, tessellation shader is used to subdivide a mesh. In 2016 WWDC, which is Apple's developer conference, Apple introduced their new metal tessellation pipeline. Metal is Apple's graphics API, but in this pipeline, tessellation shaders are the fixed function shaders. That means they are the shaders that are not programmable shaders. They are embedded inside the hardware. So we know what is fixed function shader. A shader that is not programmable and that is embedded inside the hardware. Geometry shader, as the name suggests, are used to manipulate the geometry. Geometry shader takes a primitive as input, as vertex shaders take vertex information as input. In the rendering pipeline, geometry shader comes in between vertex shader and the pixel shader. And then the compute shader. Compute shader is a general purpose shader that is used outside of rendering pipeline. That means they are not used to draw a primitive or to shade a pixel. Then what they are used for? They are used for using GPU's parallel processing capability for general purpose tasks. So that is what a shader is, and these are the types of shader based on their functionality. So that is it for this chapter. Thank you so much for listening.